I would now like to welcome Aline Hernandez to the stage to perform our national anthem with signers Madison Alvarez, Cameron Nicholas, and Rebecca Ruff. Please rise and remove your hats. Thank you, Aline, Madison, Cameron, and Rebecca. Welcome Henrietta Lacks Health and Bioscience High School Class of 2018, HeLa faculty members, friends, and family. We would first like to thank and introduce the Evergreen School District Board of Directors, President Todd Usaria, Vice President Rob Perkins, and Directors Victoria Bradford, Julie Bocanegra, and Ginny Gronwald. Thank you. I would like to thank you all for joining the Henrietta Lacks Class of 2018 this evening to celebrate our commencement. I am so proud to be a member of this accomplished graduating class. These 4 years have been long at times, but today it seems as though they went by in the blink of an eye. And that means that the next few years might feel like forever while you're living them, working hard for your degree or that paycheck, but at the end of the day, you will realize that they went by fast too. 4 years, if you're 18, is 22.2% of your life. That seems like a whole lot more if you think about it that way. Almost a quarter of your life, you've been shaped by the people sitting in front of and around you. Take them with you wherever you go. I think that's why we love those old pictures of ourselves so much. We love to see what we used to be like, because we don't remember it anymore. In the journey you're about to embark on, be aware. Not worrying that you'll forget everything and end up living in cautious need to document everything. Rather, simply be aware that time will go by and things will change. But the things to come may be even more exciting than those you're leaving behind. And if sometimes they feel like they're not, you'll always have the good old days of high school to look back on and smile about.
We are one of 26,407 public high schools that exist in the U.S. And out of all those people, the people around you are the ones you got the privilege to meet and share memories with. We decided to attend a small school where strangers become family. It will be weird not seeing the usual faces in the hallways anymore. Memories can last for a lifetime or they can last for a second. But in the end, what matters is experience. Every time I look at each of your faces, it breaks my heart a little bit how much I appreciate every one of you. Through fun times and stressful times, we all shared one memory, attending the same high school. Instead of missing calculus, I will miss seeing Mr. Hansen in the same but different colored flannels every day. Another highlight of high school has to be Derek and Nathan's AP Bio song, the song that will land them their first record label. Before the end of another experience, I want to remind you that although change is difficult, in order to complete and reach your goals, you must start.
For the long or short time we had together, we are grateful. We are grateful for the teachers, counselors, principals, associate principals, and whoever that district guy is that sings the HeLa song every Friday. We are grateful for our peers, us, the class of 2018, for the years spent at Henrietta Lacks Health and Bioscience High School. We are grateful to get to use our respectable name when someone asks us where we are from, or now, where we graduated from. Using the full name of our school, you might just get hired on the spot. As this chapter in our lives comes to a close, a world full of opportunities awaits every one of us. So, whether you are taking a gap year to travel the country, enlisting in the military, entering the workforce, or continuing your education, enjoy yourself. Have fun. Apply your unique skills to the opportunities that await you, and never doubt your potential. Congratulations, class of 2018. Welcome to your graduation.
Bring that script with you.
Class of 2018, I would now like to introduce School Superintendent John Steech.
Soon to be graduates of Henrietta Lacks Health and Bioscience High School Class of 2018, on behalf of the staff, the community, and the Evergreen District School Board of Directors, I want to say congratulations. Look around you, you see family, friends, staff members who have got you to the point you are today. I'm going to keep my comments short, but my habit with graduation is to share a specific word for each class. And the word that I have chosen for the class of 2018 is change. Of course, my notes are off. Due to change, 2/3 of the jobs that you're going to work within your lifetime don't exist today. In your high school years, you saw more change in the Evergreen School District than any class before you. You took Chromebooks home, you saw digital content, you've done community circles, you've had mindfulness. There's been a lot of change around you. However, one change that you may not be as familiar with due to Apple Pay, debit cards, and other online payments is whether getting change from the store or picking it up on the sidewalks is that pocket change that my generation knew well. We knew how to collect change, and whether we put it in the ashtrays of our cars, in cans, or in penny jars, we would collect that change over time, knowing that eventually we could buy something special, or in a time of great need, you could actually put a gallon of gas in the car. Of course, that's back when you could actually buy a gallon of gas for less than a dollar. So as you move forward in your life and you look at all the change that occurs in society and around you, make sure to collect that change and embrace that change, because it's that type of change that will make you truly wealthy in life. Again, congratulations.
Thank you, Dr. Steech. I would now like to introduce class speaker Rebecca Ruff.
Welcome, class of 2018, and congratulations, we've made it. 13 years of public education culminating for this single moment. Yay! It's incredible how far we seem to have come in 4 short but agonizingly long years. I remember the first day of freshman year looking up at the clock and thinking, why am I even awake at 7:30 in the morning? And whose idea was it to stick me in chemistry? I remember having my schedule out, desperately trying to memorize it, even though it was now the 3rd week of school. And I remember seeing the juniors, the big kids, and thinking, I can't wait to be like them when I'm older. Well, now we are the big kids, and I can honestly say I feel pretty much the same as I did 4 years ago, with some notable exceptions. I can now memorize a schedule in under 5 minutes. I can jog up all 3 flights of stairs only getting slightly winded, and have discovered the effects all-nighters have on me the next day. However, like many of you, I'm sure that being awake and learning before 8 a.m. will never be appealing to me. And even if I came back next year, the ASL room wouldn't be in the same place. Who we were then and who we are now are different versions of the same people. We've had trials and tribulations, fun and friends. We've laughed and we've cried. All these experiences have taught us lessons that shouldn't be forgotten. Never let anyone tell you that because you learned one life lesson in high school, it's less important than one you'll learn in the real world. It's just as important. Also important is trusting yourself to make decisions, big or small, because like it or not, we're going to be the ones making all our decisions from now on. So take calculated risks, even if you're not so good at math, because whether you come out on top or fail spectacularly, you will have learned something from it. Everyone knows our school motto, Rise Above. It's posted nearly everywhere you look on campus. But the beauty of that statement is that it's ambiguous. It can mean something different for everyone. It can mean to be the bigger person and not get dragged down by whatever's going on. It can mean seeing beyond yourself, seeing that others need help and knowing that you can help them. It can mean dealing with adversity in a way that is healthy and beneficial. It can mean reaching higher, meeting and raising expectations. Rise above, whatever it means specifically, is always something good. It's always about improving yourself or the world. It's a wonderful motto. That's why I believe we shouldn't abandon it, even though we're leaving at school. We should take it to heart and think about it, because when we do, we can make a difference. Even if it's just a drop in the ocean, that can make a ripple, which can make a wave. Always remember that one of the best things you can do with your life is to be kind. I'd like to thank all of my teachers, whether they be the ones I had at school, the ones at church, or the most notable of all, my parents. To anyone who has imparted hard-earned wisdom to me, I thank you. And I invite you all to think of all those teachers that have impacted you the most. They have donated their time and efforts to help you succeed, and here you are. So thank them. If you can, thank them today. Thank them for believing in you and helping you get here. Last of all, I'd like to thank you all, class of 2018, for all of the unforgettable moments that I've accumulated over the past 4 years and for the friendships I have made. Whether we see each other tomorrow or in 10 years, know this, we will always be phoenixes. And like the phoenix, we will always rise above.
Thank you, Rebecca. And now, here is our senior choir ensemble performing A Million Dreams.
Close my eyes and I can see a world that's waiting up for me that I call my own.
Through the dark, through the door, through where no one's been before, but it feels like home.
They can say sounds crazy. They can say I lost my mind. I don't care, so call me crazy. We can live in a world that we desire. Cause every night I lie in bed, the brightest colors fill
compile each one there to make you smile on a
Thank you, HeLa Senior Choir Ensemble. I would now like to introduce our final student speaker, Dakota Juarez.
Hi, my name, for those of you who don't know me, is Dakota. Before we begin, I would like to thank the parents, teachers, and family members who helped, or in my case, shoved us to the finish line. Thank you for that. We've spent approximately 12 years, 420 weeks, 2,148 days, and 12,960 hours in school. But who's counting, right? At first, when I was doing this math about a year ago, I wasn't very happy with those numbers. It seems like a lot of time to spend learning math, science, and I suppose how to read. But then I realized something. When you step into your first day of kindergarten, you start to figure out who you are, who you like to hang out with, and what you want to do. Now, of course, as kindergartners, we wanted to be a ninja or a princess, or if you're like me, a dog. But it's a start to the journey that we take. We go through a lot in school. Things are always changing, from who you sit with at lunch, to the house you live in, or state, or sometimes even country. Our journey has had highs where we felt like we were unstoppable, like when you got an A on that project you worked on for weeks, or your first relationship. But we've also had lows where we felt like the world was falling apart in our hands. Like maybe you failed a class, or you were having difficulties at home. But it's all a part of our journey, and it's what makes this, the end of the road, that much sweeter. So now I have to take back everything I said about the government tricking us into coming to school. I apologize. This experience we've had has also given us tools that we will take into our adult life and people who we will never forget. Which brings me to the summer of 2014, right before our freshman year. We attended an orientation. I knew two people from my old middle school, Y East. As I walked into different classrooms, I met new people who, if not for HeLa, I would have never met and been able to call true friends. Think of your friends. How many of them would be strangers to you if you had gone to your home high school? It's one of the advantages of coming to our school. Our school has also given us advantages going into life. How many students can say they worked with Sim dolls that have a heartbeat and can give birth at the push of a button? As students who attended HeLa, we all got classified as the nerds of the district. And I know when I was a freshman, I was extremely proud of that, and still not so secretly am. And let's not forget all of the wonderful teachers who have taught at HeLa. Just to name a few, because they're all great, but I have to bring up some specific people. Ms. DeWine, who never yelled at her students, even though they probably should have been. And for some of us, we remember the tea that she was so kind to bring in. Miss Moore, probably one of the coolest teachers at HeLa, taught us, well, that if you get on her bad side, you're probably doing stairs. Mr. Cook, who taught us more than just history, he taught us how to have fun. When you walked into his classroom, you knew you were in for a good laugh or two. Our best memories at HeLa, however, are all the events we held, like the family fun night on Halloween, or when kids and teachers went to go help the homeless at night strike. And of course, let's not forget all the dances. Like our first prom was held on a boat. How many kids can say they did that? Although this is a bittersweet moment for all of us, leaving all we ever really knew, becoming adults, being a part of the rest of the world. But that's what our journey was for, to lead us up to this moment and to prepare us for the world and to prepare the world for us. Because if there's one thing I'm certain of, it's that the Henrietta Lacks class of 2018 is gonna change the world for the better. Whether that's curing cancer, becoming a world-renowned chef, or being the next Beyonce, we're gonna take the world by storm. A bit of advice to help you get there is to not let anything get to you. The best medicine for sadness, anger, or even doubt is laughter, friends, family, and determination. Now I'll leave you with a quote by Cleo Wade. What we know now more than ever is that we don't have to wait a moment longer. The cracks in the ceiling have been made. Our light is shining through. Today we shine, tomorrow we shine, the next day we shine some more. Our future is brighter because we illuminate it. Thank you again, and welcome to the beginning of a new journey. And not that you won't hear this enough today, but congratulations, you've made it.
Thank you, Decora Morris. I would now like to introduce our final vocal performance, Irina Bijan performing Rise Up by Andra Day, accompanied by Kendalyn Hudson.
You're broken down and tired of living life on a merry-go-round, and you can't find the fighter, but I see it in you, so we gon' walk it out and move mountains. We gon' walk it out and move. To breathe, and I know you feel like dying, but I promise you we'll take the world to its feet and move mountains. We'll take it to its feet and move mountains. For you, for you, for you. that we have each other. And we will rise, we will rise, and we will rise. Oh, we'll rise. I'll rise up high like the day. I'll rise up in spite of the ache. I'll rise up and I'll do it a thousand times again. I'll rise up, rise unafraid, and I'll rise up in spite of the ache. I'll rise up and I'll do it a thousand times again. For you.
Thank you, Irina and Kendallin. I would now like to introduce Principal Julie Tumulty to present the class of 2018.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, faculty members, and especially the class of 2018. Class of 2018, you came from six different middle schools in every corner of the Evergreen School District to contribute to our school community. You are all unique individuals known to each other and to every adult in our school. You are not a number. And yet there are some impressive numbers regarding your class. I'm not talking about test scores, GPAs, or scholarships, although all of these numbers should make you proud. I'm talking about some numbers that reflect crucially important character traits, like persistence, perseverance, numbers that show your surface and your selflessness. Class of 2018, you have spent 720 days of your life actively trying to make our school a better place. Whether that was running events and assemblies, lifting up fellow students in creating a You Matter Week, or the daily gestures of friendship and kindness that consistently enhance our school culture. You work together to create yearbooks, stars in plays, compete as a team, whether that was HOSA, Science Olympiad, Knowledge Bowl, or in the 60 seasons of athletics you participated in during your 4 years. Sometimes you shined individually, but always you worked alongside others to contribute to something greater. You persisted through any challenges and showed up every day and did your job. Not only did you show up every day for fellow students, but you actively sought out opportunities to serve others for the countless food and supply drives for the greater Clark County area, serving the homeless in night strike, or simply cleaning the neighborhoods surrounding the school. Collectively, this graduating class of 138 students has volunteered for over 3,000 service hours in the school and community at large. You have spent another 2,500 hours working across our country to serve others in internships, supporting people in a broad range of tasks such as helping to fill prescriptions, assisting with physical therapy for veterans, and treating patients in memory care with dignity and professionalism. As you venture out in the real world, keep being yourself. Keep finding ways to show you care and compassion to the world around you. Keep showing up to serve others. Keep doing the good work. It is these ingrained traits that you have already developed that give me total faith that whatever the future holds for each of you, you all have the character to be successful in your aspirations, and to truly rise above any challenges or obstacles. So now the big reason why you guys are here As principal of Henrietta Lacks Health and Bioscience High School, it is my privilege to confirm that these students receiving their diplomas tonight have met the requirements of the state of Washington and the standards set forth by the Evergreen School District. Members of the Board of Directors, Superintendent John Steech, ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the Henrietta Lacks Health and Bioscience Class of 2018. It is my honor to present the diplomas to the 2018 senior class officers. Irina Bejan. Sandra Nguyen. Margarita Stepanian. Do you want me to take that? Do you guys want me to take that? Okay. Do you have your names?
Ban Alamin. Jacob Campbell. Alex Hartlow.
Yes, girl.
Erica Hike. Brianna Canode. Sarah Levy. Sheila Nguyen. Ishu Podal. Megan Sarigan. Aisha Gehad Elhout. Aline Hernandez. Cameron Nicholas. Madison Alvarez. Morgan Danskin. Mackenzie Kyan Weimer. Colby Andrea Maynor Zolo. Lexi Black. Lauren Palisso. Tyler Gray. Cassandra Borders. Akira Jackson. Sabrina Ahmed. Tony Arellano.
Lynette Attar. Drew Everest Avery. Brianna Avila. David Babarin. Brittany Bavard. Haley Bogie. Jacob Boucher. Reese Boyce. Haley Brown. Ekaterina Kalatoyu. Alejandro Cano Velasquez. Eric Castillo. Mawaya Cepeda. Edwin Chavez. Preston Chris Hamilton. Taylor Camella. Blake Conrad. Woodrow Davis. Jordan Victoria Dawson. Sebastian De La Cruz. Paulina Demyanyuk. Chimmy Dolker. Jessica M. Dum. Megan Erickson. Sebastian Furch. Kiera Fuller. Laura Flynn. Janelle Gast. Julia Jensitsky. Roman Jensitsky. Marina Gerasimov. Abigail Gligor. Ashton Gross. Garrett Guthrie. David Hator. Amelia Herbert. J.
Jade Hermida. Isabel Hernandez. Melissa Hernandez. Leilani Hill. Xavier Houston. Nathan Iblings. Brock Jacoby. Jose Joaquin Ponce. Katie Johnston. Ethan Kreider. Dennis Vasilovich Krashenko. Ashta Kumar. Matthew Lambert. Ashley Leverett. Jackson Long.
Justin Mancini. Jorge Luis Mariscal Morales. Connor Marshall. Leanne Marion. Veronica Marion. Daisy Matea. Maytaj. Matthew Miles. Declan Miller. Miguel Mullins.
Kristen Munoz. Anastasia Nahurska. Alejandro Javier Navarro. Viet Nguyen. Emily Oliver. Jeffrey Olson. Tyler Owens. Alexia Patterson. Alexander Peterson. Derek Fan. Bailey Plantenberg.
Zoe Pleath. Trinity Pressler.
Alyssa Rodsville.
Nathan Ramey. Cassidy Reynolds. Hayden Ribeiro. Joseph Riley. Brian Rivera. Kaylee Mae Russell. Anna Sandstrom. Gavin Scouten. Jesse Sidhu.
Taylor Smith. Thomas Snyder. Riley Lane Stewart.
Roman Stoliarov.
Jason Story. Sean Tabari. Joseph Tishenko. Yao Martino Bienvenu Toto Alipui. Kyla Vanderhyde. Claudine Vasquez. Angela Vuzzi. Haley Warden. Mia Welch.
Christopher Williams. Ryan Yackel. John Yukon III. Mikhail Julian Yu. Ian Zem. Vanessa Zimmen. Dan Dmitry Kravets.
Dakota Yuvia Nicole Juarez. Rebecca Ruff.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you our graduating class of Henrietta Lacks Health and Bioscience High School. Graduates, please stand up. Class of 2018, please turn your tassels. Woo! Thank you everyone for coming tonight. The rain is telling us it is time to end. So please, please, please have a fantastic evening. And thank you again for celebrating the class of 2018. For those of you heading to the grad party, meet your buses by Cascade Middle School, and everyone drive safe. Good night.